just on its own.
Okay, very
which
good.
Which I always look for.
And that's Odell's Brewery out of Fort Collins.
Out of Fort Collins, yeah.
Don't be afraid of the big guys, right?
Oh, yeah. And I love that label.
Yeah, it's
I really,
really cool
do.
It is. It's nice. I love the name on this next one.
Yeah, this is a really cool beer, actually, done by Dogfish Head, which is out of Delaware.
Now, would you say, before you go on, would you say Dogfish is one of those, you know, it's like the Silver Oak or Jordans of wine? People really look at Dogfish
well,
like that?
Yeah, well, and not only that, but these guys really strive to come up with really unique styles of beer.
Okay.
And they have what they call their Ancient Ale series, which this is part of. So they actually work with archaeologists and kind of find these beer recipes that were made throughout the ages. This particular one was, they found the ingredients in King Midas, who was actually a Greek king.
Right.
And they found the ingredients in his tomb. And if anybody knows Greek mythology at all, King Midas was known as the guy who everything he touched turned to gold. So that's why this is called the Midas Touch. And it's very unique. You don't see a whole lot that are brewed with ingredients such as honey and saffron and white muscat grapes.
Right.
So it's really unique because you have this sweetness, but it's also a very dry and very drinkable beer. Hmm. And even being at 9% alcohol, which is a pretty beefy for
big.
A beer.
Yeah.
It's still very just easy drinking. And the food pairings on this, this would be a little bit more specific food pairing. With the sweetness, with the honey and the saffron and that, I like it with Asian cuisine.
Okay.
Honestly.
Okay.
A nice Kung Pao chicken or something that has a little heat on it. Just balances very well with this.
Is this a beer lover's beer? I mean, do you have to be into beer to like this?
Honestly, no. If you're a Chardonnay drinker, you would probably really enjoy this beer.
Really?
Mainly because it has that tropical fruitiness to it. It does. It doesn't see any time of oak, but it has a little bit of vanilla, so it kind of gives you that sense of oak, I guess.
Viscosity? Does it have a viscosity?
It has some viscosity. It has a little fuller of a mouthfeel to it.
Nice.
It just kind of coats your mouth really nice. It's absolutely
so the ladies
wonderful.
Out there that like Chardonnay.
Definitely try this.
Right? That's cool.
And this guy here, we sell it both by the 4-pack and as just the single 12-ounce bottle here. The single goes for $3.49, which if you just want to try it, it's a very reasonably priced.
Right.
I mean, people will think $4 for a single
that's
beer.
The shoes.
But yeah. No, this
no,
is
I mean,
Dogfish Head.
Dogfish Head. I mean, that's just what they run.
Yeah, that's just what they run.
Okay.
And then we do sell it by the 4-pack and it goes for $13.49, which can be a little pricey for some people. So if you do want to just try a single, like I said, we do have it for just $3.49 for the
single
bottle.
You're not going to drink six of them during the Bronco game.
Oh, yeah, exactly. I mean, especially at 9%, you don't need more than one or two of them.
Okay. There you go. You have one of these and then you go on to something else.
Exactly. This is something that you start off your night with.
That's right. It's a starter beer.
Exactly.
Which is great.
Yeah, we're always joking about that you know what, you start off with the good stuff and then later on in the evening, then you can bring out the Pabst Blue.
Do that with wine, do that with spirits.
Oh yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Because after a while your taste buds are just gonna be shot, so you might as well start with something good and then when you can't taste anything, just whatever gets the job done.
Exactly. Gets the job done. Just don't get behind the wheel when you're getting the job.
Absolutely, be
don't
responsible.
That. That's right. So, three beers in the show today because the craft beer industry is blowing up.
Oh, it's huge.
And Heritage, we have how many doors?
Something over 20.
Yeah, exactly.
With tons and tons of beer. Myself, Rick, any of the managers, we have a great beer department, guys.
Right.
That if you have any questions or if you're looking for a specific style of beer or you just want something new and unique, something like this Midas Touch to try that you never thought you would like or you never thought you'd pick up or you just never even heard of. I mean, you don't really hear of muscat grapes, honey, and saffron being brewed in beer very often.
Just that alone, you have to come buy it.
Exactly.
Yeah. So tastings on Fridays and Saturdays.
Fridays and Saturdays. We do them from Fridays from 3 till 6 and then Saturdays from 1 till 4.
Okay.
Definitely come in and see us. Talk to Joel up front there.
Beer, wine, spirits.
Beer, wine, and spirits. We usually do wine on wine and spirits on Friday and then we try to do beers on Saturday.
Okay.
Although we do some wines and spirits on those days also.
Joel would say, and Justin would say too, bring your ID.
Definitely bring your ID. Joel will be asking for it.
Exactly.
But it's definitely a great opportunity to try some things that you probably maybe have seen around the store, but just have maybe been a little reluctant to pick up. So definitely a good opportunity.
So thanks for tuning in to Justin's Picks today, and come in and check out Justin's rack over here. It's the rack with all the picks on it.
Absolutely, everything that goes on these shows goes on that rack, so make it nice and easy to find for you.
And we appreciate you for the support of Heritage Wine and Liquor, heritagewineandliquor.com, and the phone number real quick
is 303-770-8212.
Cool. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thanks. See you soon.
Thanks.